Ever since I was a teenager, I have had very intense fantasies about having sex with a giant roach. It started in 9th or 10th grade when we read The Metamorphosis by Franz Kafka. As I started to think more and more about the roach creature that the character had become, I started to imagine what it would be like if a woman turned into the roach instead. I found this idea very arousing. I would not be repulsed or frightened by her, as the characters in the story are. I would take care of her. Then, my thoughts started to get sexual with the character. Eventually, I sort of dropped the bit about her having been a human first, and I kind of imagined this fictionalized roach species. They're giant roaches, the size of a person, and have complete intelligence. I kind of over time conjured up an imaginary friend of sorts. She was one of these roaches, and her name was Agatha. I would fantasize about her often. Whenever I masturbated, I'd be imagining elaborate scenarios of me and Agatha making love. When I started to have actual sex, I found I could not perform if I wasn't thinking of Agatha. So basically now, anytime I have sex with a woman, I'm pretending that she is actually Agatha. Not just thinking about Agatha, I concentrate intently to visualize that I am actually doing Agatha. I don't want to think about the girl at all. There is only Agatha. Of course, this sex can never be as exciting as my fully imaginary sessions with Agatha. There are things that her multiple appendages and antennae allow for that a human woman can never match. So, anyways, I've been in a relationship with my girlfriend for about a year now. 3 or 4 times I've tried to have sex with her and not pretend she's Agatha, but I just can't do it. So essentially every time we have sex, I'm imagining she's Agatha. I finally confided this to her the other day, and I was blown away by her reaction. I thought she might take it a bit badly at first, but that she'd get used to it.
Really?
No. I have never seen such a look of disgust before. Outraged is not an understatement. It probably is. She's not even returning my text now. I'm afraid she is actually going to break up with me and tell people about Agatha. I don't know how I'll face anyone. This is going to sound silly, but I also feel guilty about feeling shame, as if Agatha would be saddened by this.